show. I'm your host, Paul Vorton. Go Manly!
Any time that you should hear the name Manly, any time you hear Manly, you will squawk like an eagle.
We had the controversial incident on the weekend out at Brookvale where Manly defeated the...
Joey, is that injury similar to what Matty had when he retired?
No, mate, I'm not scared at all. I still want to play. I'm not good at that.
This is a Mario. and I haven't seen the next run, but I've been told that... hang on.
And look.
When was the last time you actually combed your hair?
No, I'm telling you, like I said the other night, it's great. You get up in the morning now and you go like that, and that's you for the day. It's
what about the chamois you go through? That costs a lot.
I've been named King Mushroom for the year.
Are you a champignon or the big, big wild mushroom?
I've got the big wild one, don't worry about it.
Just to hold the trophy up and kiss it for the cameras, have a look at this. Have a look at the shape of that trophy. Now, that's tops. Now, the first one for this week, I think, pretty well speaks for itself. Have a look at this. Big dick's halfway in.
Now, that's all it takes for me.
When I count to three, Matty, you'll be wide awake, and for the rest of the show, every single time that you hear me say the words bananas, bananas, you'll jump up and you'll scream at the top of your voice, I believe in fairies. And then you're going to kiss a guy, the nearest guy to you. Bananas, bananas.
I believe in fairies.
About the Williams sisters, they're just a phenomenon, aren't they? Just their style and how dominant they are. Could they beat a man? Like, if you've got a play...
I'm sure they could beat a man, no
problem.
They could
beat a man, big time. That's right, a guy... A guy ranked around about 150 ranking. Like, could one of those girls knock off... Oh, no.
live look-alike, here it is here. I don't know what it is. It's an orange. It's got a deformity.
Oh, hang on.
So it's a two-way one, isn't it? Upside down.
Yeah, no. Wish I was travelling that good.
Got a great lookalike now. I'm sure you boys will be hoping that this lookalike is of you. But we all know that it's really of Chief. Obviously, no need to get a close
Thunder
up.
Chief, the old
Chief.
Yeah. I'm sure that was Sterling from the waist down. Wasn't that Sterling from the waist down?
From the waist down, it wasn't you, mate.
Got a heart and a lung. That.
All right, the last one. Last one. Michael Amanti from Clovelly found this great shot of Sterling in a California.
Here he is lording around the kids' children's week. Play area. There's the hair.
One, two, three, wide awake. Do you like apples?
Apples? I love apples.
Good. Would you like a red one or a green one?
I like red ones.
Okay, then. There's your delicious fruit. You take a nice big bite now. There's your fruit. You take a nice big bite. There's your fruit. Take a nice big bite. Every bite's more delicious.
No, that's not mine.
No, that's terrible. That's terrible. That's the smallest willy I've ever seen. No, someone's got mine.
Who's got it?
They got my willy.
He hit him and made him cry.
What was going on?
They were picking on me.
Fold your arms and sit up straight. I think it was all your fault. What do you want?
I'm hungry, mate. I'm really hungry.
Hey, what would you fancy?
A pie.
A pie? Okay, we'll see if we've got a pie for you. That's just for you.
It's so good. got to tell you, boys, when I went down to have a shower after that, right, and I've taken the wetsuit off, and I had to send out a search party for my Morton. It was fair dinkum. It was about this big. It was magic. My missus going, where is it? Where is it?
So, Paul, what was any different?
If you haven't been to Stadium Australia, that's something on its own. Now, the other thing too...
Look, we'll take a break. 20 more coming up after the shoot, after this... this... I'll tell you what, I'm just sitting next to you and I've got your disease from last week. Normally, I never make mistakes in the show, and you know that.
No, you're going good.
Let's take a break, but as we go to the break, it's our anti-ad. Different this week. Sometimes we always wonder, But what people think about this show, what impression we're giving. We got a drawing from a seven-year-old boy during the week. Let's have a look at... There's his thoughts about what he thinks of the footy show. Now, that was after the Ober Ober show. Very good. I'd like to know how his mum gets around during the day. It's a big night tonight. Got some very special guests coming on, of course. 8 weeks to go in the rugby league and the top eight. We're looking to see who's going to make that, and it's going to condense into... There's about 11 teams can make it, and eight will. There you go. You're not helping. You've got nothing.
We've got a couple more. It's drawing not, set. Not, oh, Ty Austin from Toowoomba had a go at these two blokes. This is Laurie.
I'm happy with that.
Yeah, that's good. That's after a night out, obviously. And there's Fatty, which I think is a distinct likeness.
Very good. Good on you, Ty. Ty's 11 from Toowoomba, and he won't see 12. Good on you. It's winter's coming on. It's getting pretty cold. A couple of Peter heaters. And here's a Queensland one for me. Might be a bit tight, but and set one for Sneaky Pete.
Yeah, Matty Gertz, mate, how you doing?
Gertz, you're a machine. What are you doing?
Good, mate. That's my only cry. I just want to see you. I haven't spoken in a while. And things are going well.
I noticed that when I was watching that, you were watching that quite intently, and when you saw that bloke getting his groin rubbed, your eyes actually lit up, didn't they? Hey? You liked that, didn't you?
Definitely.
Oh, yeah. Well, they tell me it's your birthday today. They reckon you're only... Your autograph's right, are you? No.
Yes,
pass it down. Pass it down. The hair regrowth. Still, we throw the challenge out now. Put it on right now, Pete.
Come on.
Come on, we want to see...
It's got similar food in it.
I want to put... This stuff is working. Remember you tipped it on my lap? I'm telling you, it's on fire, this stuff. The boys have gone berserk. I'm telling you, you've got to get a bit of this onto you.
This stuff works.
That's just with one little rub. I mean...
It works. You've got to get this bloke on the show.
Yeah, we have.
Get him on the show.
He can do wonders for you.
Mate, Colonel Sanders. My concern is...
Finger looking good.
My concern is I actually rubbed it up here and nothing's happened.
Jason, you look like an out-of-work porno star. And now you're probably looking at me thinking this bloke's got nothing. But I was actually...
And actually, you'd be pretty good judges.
In my playing day, I was actually a speed machine.
No, Paul, you're a speed bump.
But I found you've really got to move your arms, haven't you, when you're... A lot of the kids probably concentrate on their leg power, but it's upper body as well.
Moving the arms helps, yes, that does.
Well, OK, what about... You know Matt Shervington. Have a look at his action, the movement that goes on with it...
What do you think, sir?
Is that the right kind of movement, would you think?
Yeah, I think cutting that hair might help too, though.
Okay.
Once he gets up and running,
he's got plenty of things moving there, isn't he?
Last Sunday at the showground, the Bulldogs, too good for the Roosters. Have a look at the man highlighted, top right-hand corner. Try in the grand final of
Oh.
What is going on there? And here's a young man at the back who's about to get into... enormous trouble from his parents this evening. Very embarrassed parents, I would say.
He's a young Newcastle boy too.
The fat was seen in in the Australian Women's Forum. Can we have a look? Look at this! Look at this!
This is some vision from the... This is from the Goodwill Games just recently. If this isn't you, I will think and turn it up. I didn't know you could skate.
I got similar shoulders and chests.
What about that?
That's unbelievable.
That is you.
Well, someone said it's a likeness that's been sent in. Too close to home, this one, to be anyone but you.
She's a good sort, very attractive young lady. What's the problem there? And we're not going to solve it here tonight, but to talk about it, please, I'd like you to give a big round of applause to these three. Look, a lot of debutantes, there's 10.
A lot of debutantes.
Tarts, who cares? There's 10 new players in the team.
It's an enormous game for them tomorrow night.
I thought you were going to say something.
What about the women's semi-finals? Everyone would love to see Jennifer Capriati win. Can she win tonight?
I think Capriati will just have too much for her.
Capriati, okay. Yeah. Thanks for the tip, Ken.
Ken does a great job, whatever he does, whether it's State of Origin or whatever he does.
Everything. He
on
does
the
everything.
News and stuff like that, he's pretty good. Right. Now.
And a flat bat, one crack. Crack. Well, hang on.
Hang on. There's been a casualty. Come and look out. Come on, Dale. Let's get back up here. Come on. There you go. You OK? There you go. Righto. Let's go again. And he's on. Oh, look out. Hang on. Stop it.
So don't make sure you...
make sure you don't miss it. OK?
We're going to show you our Cracker Fatty thingo in a minute, but you can win four different cars tonight. Only one of them, but there's four different cars on the wheel tonight. But first up...
No, just one car. But four from Hyundai, four cars through the year will be available, but only the one on the show.
And obviously, if looking at me, I'm Elvis in his prime. Thank you very much. I mean, Sterling, you're obviously Elvis as he would be now.
Pretty much now, yeah. Yep.
And you're obviously gay Elvis.
when the king was, I suppose, kicked the bucket's not a nice word, but where were you? I know I was at Belmont Primary School, about 8 or 9, eating little lunch, or it was big lunch, I suppose, but... Yeah. I know, I shattered. I couldn't eat the rest of the sandwiches. Devon and Pickle onions, so didn't eat them.
I was in the Commonwealth Bank, Evan and Park branch, counting a money box. Wasn't much fun.
It was 1977,
yeah.
So I was in Wagga. We actually, things moved pretty slowly in Wagga. We didn't find out till about 1979 that he'd actually... This isn't the first time you've come on here and given it to me.
Nah.
I'm going to get this. I'm going to look for a shot of the biggest arse in the world.
Well, mate, just get those old girlfriend photos.
Touching arm straight.
Here we go. Yes,
it looks
good.
Arm straight.
Get together.
Oh!
Oh, you got him. Good driving. Oh, he's down. Poor Jackson shark, they can give you a nasty suck, but that's about it. Look at him, pulling me in front of him, or pulling someone in
front
of him.
Look at the size of this thing.
He's coming back.
Here he goes. He's looking for somewhere to hide. Yeah. I'm going to hide between his legs. Shots now, Pete, you can.
Oh!
six blokes.
Okay, just warming up.
That was good. Come on, mates.
What do you got? You got nothing.
Stay there, Fatty, stay there. Hey, give us some right, no, right hand, right hand, right hand. Let's get some comfortable. Get some nice big turns. Get out in the water and lay down. Right hand, right hand.
Pete, you're the man most likely. You're the lightest, you're the fittest, you're the youngest. So, mate, there's the bar, there's the board. Mate, do us proud.
I don't know what it is with water sports with you, Blake, but this is how we do it in Wagga.
Right, let's be a daredevil dude. Come on.
Fair nigga, Matt, he's got no hope now, so I'm worried for his life, Pat.
Oh. Oh.
Here it goes, fellas. Oh, oh,
I gotta kill myself, I know, but I'm a daredevil dude!
Feeling.
Outstanding. Hey, Sneaky. Come on. Are you actually going head first or feet first? Head first.
Oh, how it. Oh.
There you go. All right, now the fat's up, so I'm going to attempt something very special. Oh, sh**.
Oh,
say sport. I don't know, did my head hit the ice then?
You're all right, mate.
Sorry, I just need to get you. You all right? Oh, mate, I'm right, Chief.
Sure?
Yeah, mate.
Let something hit this. Hit the ice real hard. Is that your head?
Oh, no, no, mate. No, it's fine, mate.
Let's go, mate.
G'day, Simon.
Hey, good. How are you, mate? Very good, very good.
Mate, that is unbelievable. That's without doubt the best water feature I've ever seen.
It's a good water for you over the past couple of months. And...
Well, I'm impressed by this.
She watches a fair bit of telly, mate, so yeah, she hasn't taken to the
Come on,
yet.
Let me hear it.
Here we are.
Jump, jump.
I'll let you.
I originally bought it for the young fella, but... I seem to use it more than him. I find it a good way to come out and relax, mate.
How about a push?
Yeah, all right.
Here the boys?
Yeah, here's the two boys.
What, they love the painting, do they?
Oh, they love to paint, mate. Zach's six and Charlie's three, and most kids come home from school and watch telly or do their thing, but these boys are straight into the painting.
They look good.
Yeah, they're pretty good, mate. They're pretty good. They've got a fair few finished products down in the cupboard. Yes, they're pretty impressive, actually. I'll show you through them.
Well, you keep some of their paintings?
Oh, we keep all of them.
So we're going to have a look at them later?
Yeah, yeah, I'll take you down to the cubby house shortly, mate, and we'll go through them.
So we've got the cubby house?
Yeah, mate, this is what I was telling you about before. We keep the kids' artwork in here. Come in and I'll show you. Just drop your head.
Watch no here. Worries. Wow.
This is it, mate.
Oh, wow, Simon, this is fantastic.
Yeah, they've sort of taken to a paintbrush from an early age.
All your kids have done this?
Yeah, the boys have done them. They, you know, they picked up a paintbrush as soon as they could walk, and that's all they like to do. They like to paint.
Back. This looks like a bit of a mood painting, Simon.
Yeah, it was. Zach really captured the moment here nicely. The cat from next door came over and ate all our fish out of the water feature, and it was a pretty disturbing time. We had to call our family over from Young to get some support off them, and that's one good thing about having the boys' talent. They really capture every moment of our life.
Birds, mate, on the weekend I was robbed. I took everything.
Really?
You know, I'd offer you a seat, but they took the lounge. No, seriously, I'd offer you a beer, but they took the fridge. Mate, they took everything. All my Australian jumpers, all my New South Wales jumpers, grand final jumpers.
So, Tez, how have the neighbours been, mate, through all these dramas?
Yeah, look, you know, I've got to give them a mention. They've been absolutely super. I mean, you know, Max over here has just been fantastic, you know, and...
He's out the back now, is he, Max?
Yeah, he is. Hey, Max.
Hello,
Tez. And, you know...
mate, I knew you loved the punt, but don't you think this is a little bit ridiculous?
I spend so much time at the track that I decided to build my own.
Hey. And mate, come on, we've come all the way up here. Why don't you just give us one lap around the little park here?
Well, if there's no noises, you got your phone off and everything?
Yeah, everything's sweet, mate.
Right up.
Hello.
Jesus, good!
Hang on, Joe.
Watch this.
Yeah, watch this. Come here, buddy.
Listen. No.
You like that?
Boys, come on, stop buddy. It.
What's in here, Joey?
That's my secret room.
Let's go in.
Ready?
Yep.
You'll love it.
Zit girds.
Oh, Joey, this is unbelievable. Not only have you got the racetrack in the backyard, you got the full-on bar in your house.
Yeah, this is where I come to get away from it. Come here to have a beer.
Joey, I did notice something interesting in this room. Over there, mate. I'm not really sure what they are.
They're beds, Gert. Sometimes I find it just a bit too far to walk to the bedroom from in here, so as I said, I'm just camping in.
There's your bed, Gert.
Not too bad, mate.
Someone short-sheeted me, though.
You don't mind sleeping there, mate.
No, I'm scared of the dark. You scared of the dark?
I'm not scared of the dark, but I believe in the boogeyman.
Obviously, with a name like Clinton, you any relation to the big man?
Yeah, actually, I'm. I've got a few photos here.
Photos there.
There's a couple there of my.
There's Bill and mine.
Bill, yeah. He's wrote something on the back too.
There's your cousin Joe, all the best. Uncle Bill and Auntie Mon go to the Penny Panther, so he's a bit of a league fan.
He is, yeah.
There's
pictures.
Oh, there's another one.
Yeah, there's another one over
cousin
there.
Cousin Joel, stick it up him, mate. I did. Best wishes.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, Joel, I love what you've done with the place.
Yeah, I can't even tell you things around.
Like the open space?
Yeah, it's pretty good, mate.
What do you use this room for?
Stargazing. Oh, yeah, it's like an observatory, you know. You get in here and have a look around. Yeah, have a look, mate.
Oh, it's probably a little bit better of a night time.
Yeah, it is.
There's got to be something big in here.
There is, mate. There is. You watch.
It's nice and tight. Tight like a tiger. What's in here?
Nothing, mate. Just
That's in the bedroom.
Yep.
Looks pretty good from the outside.
It's nice, mate. You like this one?
Oh. What's it? What happened then? Peekaboo. It's a bit of a Michael Jackson Netherlands sort of thing going on and the swing set. Looks quite nice in. How about we have a dip, eh?
Yeah, honestly, I just asked my mum. Mum! Ah. I don't know, I just had something there. I don't know if she'll let me go in.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
Sit
here? No, why not? How long's that been? we put a video or something on.
Oh, just hang on a sec, mate. Mum! Mum!
No TV during the week?
No, mate. You hungry?
Yeah, I am a little bit hungry.
Food?
Show me the pantry.
No worries.
Just walk in. Oh, no way, honey. This is unbelievable. How much food have you got now?
This is the main bedroom. So where I sleep.
No way. That's awesome. And apparently you do like the shorter women.
I do, actually.
You have no problem. Yeah. It's lovely. Thing for small women.
Here he is.
G'day, Nonny. Oh, good, mate. But what are you doing?
My wife wanted four names, but I found three really good ones, and you know, I just thought I'd put the gear on.
Doing that name thing and that, you know, you're not that big really at all, are you?
No, not really.
So, Nonny, mate, you had a bit of an injury lately, haven't you?
Yeah, a bit of a scare in the family area, but. I went to make a tackle and got kneed in the drills and thought I was a bit injured.
So the boys are a little sore?
The boys were sore and they were quite swollen. I told the trainer I couldn't run, I had to get off the field because I felt like I had 3 months floating down there instead of two.
And how do they feel now, mate?
A lot better. So I'm in operation. Keeping both of them, which is very promising. That one is going to stay about a third of it's going to be dead in the middle and the outside now is
dead in the middle?
Dead in the middle. Pretty tough, dude.
It's like a steamed dim sim.
Yeah.
Cherry?
Not funny. Cracker?
Good, mate. Enough's enough. What are you doing?
Mate, it must have driven you nuts. Well, Noddy, thanks for having their house in your house, mate. I had an absolute ball.
Good, mate. Enough. No more jokes.
Sorry, mate. I don't want to send you nuts.
Good. You're really getting me up to there. I'm real tall.
Testy.
Oh, how do you like that, huh?
I'll see you next time on Bear House. All the plans.
Listen closely. Multiply 7 and 8, add 4, divide by 3, and take off 15. Adam?
20.
5. See, now you've been G'd up, see, and I added the take off 15. The answer's 20, but sorry, it's 5. So you lose. Bob Geldof finalised his divorce from Paula Yates today. Complete the name of his hit song, I Don't Like
Women.
With which sport do you associate the terms flashing and butt ending? Glenn. Cricket. Sorry?
What was the question again?
No.
Check that. The terms flashing and butt ending.
He said cricket.
Midget throwing.
In what country was Kamal born? It's a multiple choice. Malaysia, Dilmah or Moldavia?
Dilmah.
That's a T, isn't it? Dilmah T.
Elvis's manager was Colonel who?
Hogan. Spud.
Sanders.
Multiple choice again. If I was a campanologist, would I be A, a scoutmaster? B, on a Mardi Gras float, or C, a bell ringer?
You'd be on a float.
Well, and if you're not, you should be.
Which golfer is known as the bear? Jimmy?
Fuzzy Zola.
You've got no idea, have you? What's this footage of the bears in action? Answer the following questions.
Oh, dear.
Which of the six had a sock down their pants? David?
All of them.
That'd be Jason Taylor.
Well, you'd know. I mean... Okay, Dipsy, La La, Poe, and Tinky Winky are stars of what?
The Teletubbies.
Teletubbies, yes. Favourite show?
One of
favourite show for Ryan Girdler. And extra point if you can tell me which Teletubby was rumoured to be gay. Yes?
Dipsy Whipsy.
Have a look at this piece of vision from a recent Newcastle Norse game, and we'll ask you a question after it.
We're under the last 5 minutes in this game. North City doing their best to throw the ball around, and mistakes like that can happen.
Okay, it's a multiple choice question. What was Jamie Goddard looking for in Scott Conley's shorts? Was it his car keys, a missing tab ticket, a contract with the London Broncos, or a punch in the face?
Punch in the face.
No, mate, contract with the London Broncos. Sarcophagus.
That'd probably be a sarcophagus, wouldn't it?
No. It's a Greek flesh container. Spell it. Sarcophagus.
Can you say it?
Yeah, say it again for us.
Yeah, I know.
I
know what it is.
Well, tell us what.
Sarcophagus. Can you spell that?
S-A-R-C-O-G, S-A-R-C-O-P-H.
Yeah.
A-G, sarcophagus.
You're a genius, absolute genius. There you go. Who's the major sponsor of the Bulldogs? Brad.
That's a very good question.
Phone a friend.
Phone a friend. Phone a friend. Yes.
Yes, Dick.
Bradley, realestate.com.
Well done, Rick. Lucky you can read.
Thank you.
It's very good. Very good reading up that. Who is the new head of the NRL? Is it Alan Moffat, David Moffat, or Miss Moffat? Will.
Alan Moffat.
No!
Start racking the grey matter. How do you know when your host is in a cranky mood? Sterlo, when's Fatty in a bad mood? And Sam, how do you know when Eddie's in a bad mood?
It's a simple one. Simple one.
Is it? Flatulence.
It's not my fault.
My hair turns red.
Keep an eye on the wicket keeper. Watches the back of him. Oh. What is happening there?
He's caught behind.
What former great Queensland winger had the same name as what that keeper had been eating? Yes.
Shitter.
Part of the choice. Who had a hit single with the song Rooster? Was it Alice Cooper, Alice in Chains, or Alice from the Brady Bunch?
Yes? Alice from the Brady Bunch.
Alice from the Brady Bunch. In the current women's top 10, three players... no, OK. Mate, there's questions, there's numbers. In the current women's top 10, comma, three players play with a single-handed backhand. Name two of them.
Martinez and... Hennen.
Hennen, and did you say Maresmo? No.
Yeah.
Excellent. Yeah.
Shooters.
Shooters, exactly right, because all three girls are shooters.
$50.
Oh, yeah! Oh!
You're in. Could you just have a quick shot? Of course, there's nothing you can't do.
You know that. The suit, and the suit's got caught.
Nah.
What was the score in round one between the Broncos and the Cowboys?
Broncos 18, Cowboys 17.
That's exactly right.
24-24.
24-24,
yes. 34 Eagles, 42.
That's right, yeah. You're a freak. Which Roosters player's first name is also a country in Africa, where they recently found what is believed to be the skull of the world's oldest man?
Skullosaurus.
I think it's, yeah.
Craig.
Just where exactly in Africa would that be, mate?
Just, it's about 40 k's out of Nairobi.
Yeah. It's actually Chad. Peter O'Toole starred in Lawrence of Arabia. Falcon.
Gone!
He's alive! You're gone! Oh, mate, the haka. Roy Henry, come out right here. Come out in front of the kit. Come on, come on. Get into it, champ. Sing 10 seconds of your mum's favourite song. Joel.
Everywhere you go, I miss you. If you're not around, I need to kiss you. I love you. I love you too.
That'll do, please.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Supercoach has gone mad, please.
Who was the last Supercoach to win a premiership sporting a mullet?
Gus.
Gus.
Let's go to the tape.
You've just had a little baby. She must be keeping you up a fair bit during the night.
Yes, he is, Rusty.
Mate, we'll be looking for a few relieving penalties out there, mate. What do you think?
Jeez, I wouldn't mind a relieving penalty right now.
We'll get back to him later.
No, I've been pretty quiet, actually. I said he'd had a press day today and that, and I hadn't seen him, so... Oh, I might have seen him
tonight. Here I am with the famous Queensland State of Origin manager, Jabba the Hutt. Here I am with the famous Queensland manager, Chris Choppy Close. Choppy, mate, how's the camp been so far?
Good, thanks, Sausage Neck.
Have you got any message for your teammate, Daniel Wagon?
Hello.
I've got Trent Barrett with me. He's asleep, he doesn't know, but I'll just wake him up. Trent!
Where, man?
What time did you get home last night from the bonding session?
I think it was just about 8:30.
What?
Oh, I don't know.
Who's your favourite player?
That's James.
Okay, and what is it about Marky? Is it his speed, his strength? What do you like about him?
Body?
I know, you just told me to.
Thanks, sir.
You've been playing really well this year. You've found some good form coming off. It's a Falcon.
I reckon the physio is a bit of a switch hitter. He bats and bowls. So you better watch him.
His long nails are digging in a bit there.
Jason, is there any truth to the rumour that you could well be the best looking prop on the field tomorrow night?
Yes.
I just want to sing for you now because I don't like talking footy all the time. Because I'm walking away. Troubles in my life, I'm walking away. You like that?
Best out there for Captain C, because you know if you don't do your job, I'll be the next captain.
I just want to know, can all you see Wendell in his background?
This is the Knight Rider.
Who the are you?
What?
You heard me.
Joey. The camp so far, it's been good. And what do you think the best bit has been?
Medical. I like the medical. When everyone's walking around their underpants, in a strange sort of way, it makes me feel like a man.
What should I talk to Wayne about? Because he doesn't like talking about footy.
His long back, his big ears, his long neck. Why? Just ask, say, Wayne, why do you never smile? Just ask him something like that.
He always smiles at me.
Oh.
I wonder why.
I thought you'd make him smile.
I've been, like, watching you forever, since I was, like, 4 years old. You seem so much younger in real life.
Christ's
sake. How'd you go with your meat?
It looks good. Nice and tender.
Mate, it looks like something you'd see on the side of the Pacific Highway.
Roadkill.
There you go, boys. That was the Dragons cooking class for the...
Oh. I had Brian Brown's down the snow this weekend. Remember that movie, Cocktail? For goodness sake.
Oh, did you run? You know, it was a big build-up with you and Gus. Did you get him in the grandstand? Did you drop your shoulder in him or anything? Was there a head eye or...?
No, well...
I reckon he would have snapped you.
You're probably right. Probably right. Well, talk me to death anyway.
MG was the guest host this night, and we sent a taxi out to pick him up. Now, there's a hidden camera in the taxi, and also there's an actor, a setup in the front seat. Now, his sole purpose is to annoy MG. Now, MG thinks he's late, he's panicking. Now, we pick it up with this guy stopped for the third time for a toilet stop, and he's blowing up. Have a look at this.
So you cool now? No more shit stops?
What would happen if you're late?
Well...
They won't put you on TV? Then I wouldn't get a go have a ticket. If you're not on.
There you go, so no more shit stops, eh? There you go, buddy.
I thought you were talking to me.
No. I was on the way there, on the way to Channel 9. Then I've got to go to back to Channel 7. I'm on a cab ride from hell, I tell you.
Right? I'm in heaven because I got a star in the car.
Fuck! Man, John. I've got a f***ing headache, hey. Mate, come on.
Just a little bit.
What the f*** is that? Hello? Stop the cab. Mate, we're right in the middle of the traffic here. He said, hop out now. Look, what's behind him?
What's the matter?
Hello?
It's the middle of the road.
Oh, f***. Come on. Thing. What's John's guy? Is he a f***ing plant? Is he?
You.
Hi. My name's Norm Gray. I'm a professional daredevil. You may have seen me a couple of months on The Footy Show. I plan to jump across Sydney Heads in a rocket-powered motorcycle.
We'll be jumping from south to north head. We need 10,000 pounds of thrust. That'll put me 2 kilometres high.
I reckon they just put a coffin in the middle of the ocean. That's where you're going to land, Norm.
Today we're at the Central Coast Convoy for Kids, where I intend to jump 12 cars, a relatively straightforward jump. I really couldn't quite get up enough speed to do this distance here. I had a feeling things might go this way, but I didn't want to disappoint anyone. I'm not sure what happened. Did I hit the last car? Yeah.
I'm Steve Irwin, Crocodile Hunter, and this
is my zoo.
Hey, I'm Steve Irwin. I'm the crocodile hunter, and this is my zoo.
Steve, I thought this was our zoo.
Hey, it's not your zoo, it's our zoo.
Great, mate. It doesn't matter whose zoo it is. It's going to be insane. Let's go.
Great, mate, great state of origin training. Get the boys in here running around. Come on, girl.
He's a lunatic. What?
So can I come in there too or not?
Yeah, come on. Whatever you do, mate, just don't let it get you on the ground. Here she goes. And watch out, mate, because they sideways kick like cuts. Steve, it's all right.
Where's another carrot?
That one, Steve.
Give me a long one.
Pretty good. Steve won't be getting lucky tonight.
Well, watch out, mate. They've got a very powerful bite. Although they've got no teeth, their beak is so sharp that it could remove your hands in one single chomp.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely.
What is it?
It's a mouth.
No, it's...
It's a tortoise. It's a land tortoise.
Watch out from that one over there.
He'll be here in half an hour.
A few of the people have been said they're pushing on them. And
prior
so
to mating. That's
if you
actually
push
the
on them enough, they get an erection.
Oh, really?
So the staff would say, why do the tortoises keep getting an erection every time we put them in the cave? And that's why you can't push on them.
You need to just push on me for a minute. You ready to feed this bloke, Steve?
Absolutely. Come on, Graham. Be careful, Steve. Thanks, Terry. I'll help you from back here.
Just approach him a little further. Wiggle it so he can see it. Okay, he's looking. He's looking.
Yep.
He's looking.
Come on. Come on, champ.
Back up.
There you go. Duh.
Good work. Unreal.
You're an absolute good Steve. I've got to go to the toilet, Terry.
Hi, Steve Brooker here, the fullback for the Greta Gorillas. We play a big game today against the Curry Bulldogs, and I'm getting married too at 2 o'clock just before the game.
Everything has to go around the football. I mean, we've got 15 minutes to complete it, and then it's just football as usual, just every, like we do every weekend, just go to the football.
Deep breath. Get out there, chopper. You gotta be fortunate.
You gotta be lucky now. And I want to commend both Chris and Jackie on their originality. Steve and Jackie on their originality and also on their love of their football team. For taking all others keep only unto him so long as you both shall live.
Yep.
Yep.
On you, babe!
We're full time here today at Greta and...
Yeah, but in the other big match, it's just the beginning.
Your major policy document is about sports funding, isn't it, Trent?
Yes, we need some more funding. Yeah. Wynn Stadium needs a new grandstand.
How much do you need?
What about $10 for the socks?
Yeah. Prime Minister of Australia, John Howard, sir, good morning.
Good morning, Jeremy. Nice to be back.
Great to have you back. Just when we thought we had this wretched railroad in the bag after nearly 100 years, we have more trouble this morning.
Yes, this is in relation to the 26 million. Federal government said several weeks ago that it would put up its 26 million.
Hello, Nathan.
How you going, buddy?
Good.
Good?
Hello, Nathan.
I'll see you later, are you, man?
We got our...
Have you? How you going, buddy? What's your name?
Alex.
You must be Daniel, are you?
Yeah.
How you going, buddy? You invited me for tea?
Yeah.
So I thought I'd come and join you, mate. Is that okay?
When they give you the $100 or $1,000 Man of the Match award, is it a certificate or is it money in there?
No, it's just a certificate. That's all right. This is a family portrait on the black sheep of the family. No. The tea was delicious, okay? I think I'd love to stay and do the washing, but I've got to go now, so. All up to you guys.
Thanks for coming, I really appreciate it and I'll never forget it.
Start the straining! Upside down!
Oh, he's gone ballistic. Water everywhere, I'm soaking.
Oh. I'm going to give you the controls and I want you to roll the aeroplane.
You just tell me what to do.
Yeah, Roger D. Roger D, mate. Pull the nose up slowly. Up, up, up. Full stick left, left, left. Roger D, take it left. Roger D, I have the controls.
Thank you.
The black guy over here is calling me a wanker. You wanker! You wanker!
What did it mean to you personally to be the leading referee or the all-time great referee of all time?
Which part do I answer
somebody
first?
Stop me. Lot of all just say something.
We had a great relationship, Bill and I. He's the only referee to actually send me off. He sent me off at the sin bin there one night. I walked up to him and I said, Bill, I said, what would you do if a player called you a cheat? He said, I'd send him off. I said, oh. I said, what would you do if a player thought you were a cheat? He said, I couldn't do anything about that. I said, good, I think you're a cheat.
If you want to get anywhere, you've got to be able to speak Russian. That's what it's like, yeah.
Can you give me something in Russian? Do you learn
anything? Strasvodazhye? Or something like that?
Can I have a sausage? Was that... Sausage?
You tell them about your days on the hill of Brookvale, cheering for the fat.
Honestly, who was your favourite player?
All about fatty.
With all due respect, do your folks own a pub?
Why?
I'm just thinking, you're beautiful, you're rich, and you love rugby league. They own a pub, you're the perfect lady. You're the perfect lady.
Oh, I was just wondering, Sarah, on the modelling catwalk, is there a vacancy for like a 5'9", 91 kilo bloke from the coalfields?
Has this been a secret ambition of yours?
Oh, might need a bit of waxing in that.
You know, we'd all love you to stay where you are.
And what's that, Fat?
Walkers on.
Walkers on.
Oh, hang on. Oh, hang on. Walkers on. all right. Oh, look out. Walkers on. Walkers are on.
How was it sitting through the Origin series this year?
Oh, mate, yeah, it's never easy, but, you know, it was a good result, I guess, in the end. But,
explain that to us. What do you mean?
I don't know. I'm just lost for words.
he's down in the mouth. He's...
We want to see you married or engaged by the end of the year. So we're launching Steve O's Search for a Girl competition.
What are you looking for in a girl? What?
Mate, just with that past experience, I'd just be happy with a girl.
what about yourself? I still can't get over the 7 year celibate. That's unbelievable. I mean, what happens if just say a glamour walks in front of you, get a little impure thought, and Mr. Happy starts to, you know? What happens then?
And I couldn't get a babysitter, so I've decided to bring the kids on. Is that okay?
Well, the kids?
Yes.
What do you think it is, a kindergarten one? What's your nickname for Uncle Joey?
I don't know.
You call him?
Horsey.
You call him Uncle Horse because Joey's always sitting in front at the tab watching the horses.
No, it's not. He used to come in the sheds after the game and for some reason he calls his dad Poo Poo.
Let's have a look at this week's entries for Jason to pick a date.
Glamours.
Steve, no more sadness. I want to be the one to make you happy. But you, Steve, could be the one to change my point of view. Hi, Jason. I believe we have a lot in common. I'm a nun, and you get none.
What are you looking for in a girl, Steve? I mean, you're leading all these young ladies along. I mean, you told me that your ideal woman looks like Dustin Hoffman and Tootsie.
You look quite... strong up top. People try and take you up top and they sort of bump off you. You got nothing down below. I mean, look,
you've
got legs like
the
a chicken
anyway.
Legs and sparrow ankles. But obviously you look at me and you think Elvis in his prime. Early 20s. So what was it about me that attracted you?
It's the sideburns.
The sideies, the mutton chops.
Priscilla, why did you leave me?
It's unbelievable. I mean, I've come in after a shower and he's sitting over there and he's down there. Just so, for instance, these are his thighs here and he's going, come on, are you ready? I've put a lot of work into you, babies. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. Yeah. Wendell, don't let me down. I want you. I mean, just really gets fired up. I mean, you know, I know Adam McDougall will show up there tomorrow night at Cowtex Oval and he will have his football boots on.
I do the same thing. I'm not talking to my thighs, though. Come on. Something. You know, when you're struggling sometimes, fellas.
A young bloke here married off season.
Yeah, Nathan Brown. Nathan. How's that going?
Yeah, it's going fine. Yeah? Hello to Tanya. She's at home right now watching.
You remember her name? That's good.
Yeah, there's not too much rivalry, I don't think. We just.
It must be a bit different, though. Playing seven rowers together, like packing down in the scrum together.
Well, I don't know. I don't talk to him. We only come together in a scrum, so that's about it. Yeah, sort of like we're both playing on the edge a little bit, so we go our own way, and that's about it.
Well, thanks very much for coming.
Tell you what, I've got a good job for you when you come back too, mate. I've got a little area in my garden. I need a great little garden home, so if you're doing nothing, mate, I've got the job.
Looks like you spat that wheelie bin out and swallowed an industrial bin, Toppy.
I'll tell you what, Sticky, you're giving the impression that you're a nice bloke. You're the best sledger. Well, actually, you're the second best. Craig Conwell was the best.
Yeah, I actually played against Craig. I got a few lines off Craig.
Mate, you're well versed.
What were some of the sledges? Come on. What,
mate, in reference to me?
What's it like having a brother with the nickname of Nobby?
Nobby, yeah.
What do they call you?
Thimble. Thimble.
They call you Thimble.
It's better than what they call me. Sister, they call her No Knob.
You wake up every morning at 3 a.m.
Yeah.
How do you do it?
Well, I just go. Hang with Tommy here, Jack, because what he bloody inspires in the players, what Fatty don't got, you know, is the health thing, see? What he teaches them is health. He says, boys, respect your bloody bodies. Your body's a temple, mate.
After 15 minutes, I was all right. Oh, those first 10 minutes. I could never think where I was.
He's not too sure about grand final pressure.
I'd be good to be out there, it'd be pretty nerve-wracking. Big crowd, but I'm not going to get nervous.
Now, most importantly, what do you think of bald men?
I'm just, you know, I have a special kind of soft spot for men with receding hair. I mean, that nice length hair and just that, like, gentle receding hairline.
That's a perfect answer. Thank you very much, Alan Pearson. What's your best punch?
Best punch? I've got lots of punches, but I'll show you one.
What about your garden in the nude?
That's fairly obvious, isn't it, mate?
Oh, yeah, you're right, Tom. Very attractive. Thanks for spending 60 seconds with Stella. What's your worst habit?
My worst habit? Come this way.
I wish you'd stop grabbing it like that. Let's see the thing that you're most proud of.
Come this way.
Firstly, Jean-Claude, what's the best thing about Hollywood?
Oh.
In your own time.
Yeah, the best. The question again, please. Go for it.
All right. Second chance. What's the best thing about Hollywood?
Yeah, what's great, you can find out who you don't want to be sometimes.
Yeah, that was worth the wait. What's the one thing that you can't do without?
With my friends?
Oh, whatever.
Cannot do without them? You mean they have to be there, not to be there?
Oh, forget about your friends.
Sorry.
What's your worst habit?
I'm very impatient.
The best advice you've ever had?
Just to believe in what you want to do in life and to say thank you in advance, no if.
So that's it. That's the good advice.
And that's the best advice I can give them too.
And finally, at last, if you were down to your last $10, what would you spend it on?
Three boxes of oatmeal, Quaker, and a big bucket of like those 2 gallons of water. That will take me for two and a half weeks to live in. I'll make from now to then like $1,000.
Yeah, couldn't put it any better myself. Thanks for spending the longest 60 seconds with Stella.
That's good.
From one redhead to another, any advice for our own Paul Vorton?
Please explain.
If you became Prime Minister, what would be the first thing that you would do? About to become a recording artist, what's your favourite song?
Yeah, yeah. Yours too, Pete.
Yeah. You've done it all. What would you like to do now?
Do it all over again. Get it better this time.
Here he goes. Matty Johns doing it. The jump for Cash. There he goes. He's flying. He's going to break the record here. He is flying. He goes. What about that? Here's the chief. He's off. He's looking, he could go anywhere. It's Eddie the Eagle. He's right up, it's a beautiful jump. Oh, that is outstanding. That is outstanding. That's by far the longest jump we've seen tonight. Fatso is off. And he's flying, he is flying. He's got the middle, this is gonna be brilliant. Oh, and a lovely dive to finish off with. That, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the best Beat the Boys I've ever seen.
No victory.
Go on,
he's the big fellow.
Go on.
He's not going to make it. Yes, he did. It's a strike. Matty the Buttocks Johns. Oh,
not going to reach.
Hold on, champ.
Someone get in the back because I can't. Move over, Chief. Let me in. I've got to get in. Move over, Chief. Big Chief. Chief's How's that?
what's
you
great?
Stay that side. You go that side, Sterling.
Is there a difference or what?
Here he comes, Al.
Oh! Here we go. Let's hit. Hang on. Now, mate, if you stuck around long enough, that hairstyle would come back into fashion, but you don't mind getting rid of it?
No, that's fine.
Phil?
Sit down, mate.
That's disgraceful anyway, so I can only be an improvement.
Ready to go?
Nice touch. That's a nice touch. Have a look. Turn around. Have a look from both. Nice. Keep going around. Nice.
Got a roof.
30 seconds is up.
It hasn't got a moon roof.
Hasn't got a what?
Hasn't got a moon roof.
35 seconds is up.
What's a moon roof?
Well, what do you got? Sunroof.
It hasn't. Okay.
Catch up.
Come on, quickly. Come on.
There's nothing more I can tell you.
Come on, say something, Rabbit.
I've told you all I can tell you.
It's a long nose.
Sterling, I can't help you.
Okay, we're going to suck the ball in the belly. The ball goes down, the key comes up, the ball comes back. Oh, great. Oh, that's a great ball.
In the bayou, it was way behind, it was willing to make some deals. When he came across this young man, I saw him play, he's too hot. He jumped up on that hickory stump and said, boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know, boy, but I'm a field player too. And you care to take it there, I'll make a bet with you. You play pretty good field, boy, but give the devil this due. Cause I bet I'm feeling gold against your soul to say I'm better than you.
Here they go. Ready, Lawrence and Laurie. Here they come, now here they go. Up and over. Goal!
Did you see that? Again, the outer captain.
Survive. Listen,
Cole, mate.
Now if it's a spider,
well, two beautiful funnel webs, mate.
Oh, what are you going to do with them?
Well,
when they get ready to strike, we'll see if we can do it. Oh, see that? Whack, oh, like that. Oh, see that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can get one of these little cuties out here.
Now, these are they're dead set deadly.
Oh, mate.
How quick are they across the ground?
Oh, slow, mate.
Slow as.
Oh, yeah, really, really slow. Like, dead set. They're aquatic. Swim pretty good. Like, swim as quick as we could, but on the ground, mate, really slow. And that's about flat out. That's about...
Yeah!
Hi, remember me? I'm Peter Sterling. Be smart. Jump in a Blue Haven pool today. The water's fine.
Right on, Snorky. Look at the boys enjoying heated winter fun in crystal clear Blue Haven magic.
Smart for your budget.
Our family jumbo model won't put a crack in your savings.
Smart for your lifestyle.
That's right, Nullarbornos. They just love it.
Blue Haven. We'll beat all other offers because we don't give a shit.
And the horse you rode in on.
Ah, more Cab-Sav Frank.
And more Pavlova Frank. All that good stuff.
And you can't leave alone, can you, Frank?
What are we gonna do with you?
Hey!
No!
No!
No! Oh, help us, help us. Why doesn't he ever give us a hand?
He hasn't been up for years.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Café latte, Percy.
Baguette, croissant.
I prefer the sandwich.
Is it Helga's?
Naturally.
I prefer Helga's too.
And Sissy boy, I would like a Helga's too. Helga's!
Helga! Punch out another loaf, will you?
Helga's, baked fresh and steaming every day.
Wilson, you wimp! Get in there, Wilson! Oh, you're a wimp, Wilson! You're useless, Wilson! What did you come here for, Wilson? Give it to him! Wimp! You're a wimp, Wilson! You're a wimp, Wilson!
Early man, and it's not a pretty sight. The hunter-gatherer's first instinct is to find food. Unable to find food, his next instinct is to find love. After failing to find love, he returns to finding food. Any food. Luckily, someone's thinking. Amazing. Neolithic to modern man in the time it takes to eat a bowl of cornflakes. And just as amazing, modern man to Neolithic in the time it takes to pass wind. Have you woken up to the taste of cornflakes? Sure you have. But have you woken to the smell of early man?
Ah, kids, mine and dad has a bowl. Great. James, deep gully. Deep. Arthur, garage door. Ivy, fence. Lance, long off. Ready, son? Arthur! Arthur!
Hey! Dad?
Mate, why do they grunt like that? Is it for extra power or like commitment to a shot, or was it just to put the other player off?
Mate, they're not wearing comfy undies.
Comfy undies? I tell you what, Rafter, I don't know much about tennis, but I know a lot about rugby league. And that, my friend, is what you call a dominant tackle.
Your spat petite niam.
Your spat petite niam.
Is iron protein.
Is iron protein.
Is iron calcium.
Is iron calcium.
In a tub for children.
In a tub for children.
Very good, Jerome.
Very good, Jerome.
No, that's enough.
No, that's enough.
C'est fini.
Your splat. It's French
for harmless nuclear testing.
When you get that certain craving, nothing else will do. You need to try KFC's new chunky chicken pie. Oh, those tasty chunks of chicken, corn, carrots, peas, hot creamy sauce in a delicious fluffy pastry.
Sorry, sir, wrong restaurant. We don't serve junior burgers here.
KFC's chunky chicken pie. Go on, satisfy that.
He's back.
Mr. Cooper, there's a problem.
I seem to have chipped your point. Are you okay?
Spot of indigestion.
Statistically, heartburn and indigestion are common problems. Be my guest. And remember, if heartburn persists...
Oh, tear it out. Oh, hold this while I get back.
Mr. Cooper, I believe you ordered this.
Hang on a sec. Hello. No, we're doing it now. Jack and I. He's a real little trooper. No, it'll be fine. It'll be done by the time you get home.
Using Selly's No More Cracks squeeze is as easy as...
No!
Selly's No More Cracks. If it says, it works.
Excuse me, have you got any jazz CDs?
This is a pet store.
Stuffy.
Lisa, for purchases that give you no credit whatsoever.
Excuse me, have you got any jazz CDs?
At least we know how we went wrong.
Just go ahead and get some dinner. What do you got? How much for this?
10,000. 10,000.
2,000. Two.
Okay.
Came in third. Yeah. We're still taking the bait out. Yeah, look, that's my half hour. Here's your...
Daniel.
Hello, Mum.
Daniels.
I'm well. Mm-mm, it's great.
We've tested new trunk calls for lonely boys. He'll know your ring anywhere.
Yeah, Mum, the T-shirt came in.
Real handy.
Just make sure you don't catch an STD.
Go!
G'day. I've been called fatty for a long time now. In fact, I've been called a lot of things. A player, a coach.
Peanut.
Jackass.
You idiot.
Ace it up, boys.
Dickhead.
Oh, turn it up.
Hey, Nuffy.
That's a little harsh.
Hey, wanker.
That's a
Carrot Top.
Come on, boys.
Hey, Tweedlepie.
Easy, easy.
Nitwit.
I'm just doing my best.
Ginger balls.
Being professional athletes, we'll
see you, mate.
Okay, this 5-year-old's laughing at you. Do you want me to take him out?
Yeah, take him out.
Where is he? He's I'll give it to him.
Okay, Fatty.
Face it. This is the kids' school. What's going on? We're better than this.
They're the gun kids, aren't they, bud?
The gun kids. I think they've got you guys covered, you know?
Right, that's enough, yeah. All right, have good fun now. Someone's going to take an eye out.
Watch out, move.
Ready?
All right.
And that's the art of dismounting. Go help me out, mate.
No way I can say that.
Yeah. Oh, you're a two-man job. That's how big you are. You're a two-man job.
I'm not going anywhere.
Go, big boy.
And that's how you stop. Oh, that catch. I mean, what a catch. It was one of the great days of my life, actually. I was a huge cricket fan growing up during the 60s and 70s. And I got to play with that day some of the greats of that era. Greg Chappell, Dougie Walters, Joel Garner. They were just heroes in my eyes, and just to be on the same field of them was fantastic.
Oh, Fatty is going to complain about that. The keeper, the Australian keeper, missing one off his bowling.
I took an earlier catch. Doug Wallace smashed one through mid-wicket, and I caught it out in the boundary. No dramas, just a simple, straightforward catch.
Well, there's a little tester for the outfielder. Ah, that's well caught. Well caught by Paul Bolton.
And then we were sort of getting in a bit of a rut. And how was I to know that, you know, within 15 seconds I would take probably the greatest catch ever to be seen on a cricket field?
That's in the air. Who's underneath that one? This is going to be a catch. Is it? No. Oh!
I must have been 70 yards away. I'm sprinting for it, fast as I can. The little legs, the little chubby things. You know, very, very fast. And I'm looking up and I'm thinking, oh, I can't possibly get there. But then, as I ran faster and faster, there was a ray of hope. I'm thinking, well, I'm some hopey. I'm going to get this. And I just one last surge, my inner strength came out, and I stuck my hand out, and it plopped into my right hand. What really excited me was that both the teams just ran out in the field and surrounded me. And I had blokes like Ian Healy and Greg Chappell and Jeff Thompson going, greatest catch ever. Great, unbelievable. How'd you catch it? Is this the best ever? Joel Garner, oh, great catch, man. All the legends. I've just got to say, you know, it was.
Except around the genitalia region where this harness tended to get a little tight.
How's it?
Hey.
There you go, brother.
Jeff, how you going,
mate? Good to see you, mate. What's that going? Hello there.
Hello,
that's
my brother.
Wisdom. Nice to meet you.
Nice flowers. Thank you very much for that.
Some flowers and some traditional sweets.
Baklava.
There you go. That's what they're called.
Thanks, sweet.
Mate. I've got them this.
It's a little lamb, yeah.
Hello, darling.
Yes, I hope you're hungry, as I said, mate. We've got a real good food for you, you know.
A bit of
mixture, you know, a bit of chicken, lamb, everything, you know.
Seems like a bit of a challenge.
Yeah.
I'm up for it.
Oh, mate.
You good in the tooth? Wisdom, love a feed, mate, right in the tooth?
Mate.
Yeah, mate. Let's get in.
You gotta eat, you know. You gotta grow.
Oh, no.
Mate, you're a good thing. Gaz goes off all the time.
Some chicken.
You gotta be 6 foot out. You're tall enough, big fella, to get up there?
It's handy now.
Playing touch football and mucking around a school with your mates. In your wildest dreams, would you ever thought that you'd be playing for Australia in a matter of 10, 12 years?
Nah, never. Actually, like, funny thing is, even when I was, like a young fella playing, I used to just sort of, you know, when watching the games, say my name, oh, Majory, you're Majory. Does that sound, I don't know, doesn't sound like a good rugby league player now, no.
Gets the ball away from El Masri. El Masri will score. Has him, El Magic.
Well, there's hardly enough room for a plate, for a glass here. That's just all food. And all homemade.
All homemade, mate. Yeah. She's a great cook, you know.
You're a legend. So the whole family, your father, that since the move out to Australia, they've enjoyed it.
It's been great, you know. Mum will never go to a game, to be honest. She's never been to one here. I'll encourage her all the time. She just refuses to, you know. She keeps on saying, oh, I can't see my son going out there, and it's a rough sport, you know. The only game she's been to be honest, is the one we played in Lebanon, because we during the year we went overseas played down there for the Lebanon side. And
what was it like? Tell us
about it. Excellent, to be honest. I haven't been back home since I came out here, so, you know, to go
since
back.
It's the first time you've been
here? Yeah, to go back there, you know, like after 16 years or so, and just to catch up with all my family members.
Mate. I'm basilled. I'm as full as a centipede sock drawer. Mate, thanks for a great food. That was awesome.
I haven't finished yet. There's still something on the plate.
Mate, you're killing me. tell us a bit more about your dad. You're saying he's getting into the rugby league and enjoying it. He must have been super proud last year, because I remember the game say clearly you're playing the Newcastle Knights. One of the games of the season last year. You kicked that goal.
No.
Does he like watching that game?
Mate, that's
quite enjoyable.
It wasn't just a whole lot of my career. I think that's a whole lot of his career. It's amazing, you know. Like I think he's played that tape about, you know, 30 to 40 times, I think, you know, in the span of two months, you know. But as I said, like, I turned up, and every time, like, if I'm there visiting in there, out of nowhere, he'll just play the video, and it's already in there, and he'll play the last 3 minutes, and, like, just to get the sort of the feeling and the climax of it, and then he'll watch the game, and then all of a sudden, yeah, you know.
He just
like,
hustles.
It's like
you
kick the kick, you know.
Yeah, it's like
he
just happens all the time.
I mean, he has a look at each other like a...
it's like it just happened, you know, as well. Like, every time it's the same reaction.
Oh, mate, what about that? That was a massive food.
There's two more to come, yeah.
There's more.
Yeah, we've got
look at the
Chief, you're sorry, mate, but you're going to have to finish these off, too. So,
This is amazing. What about that big chocolatey round thing with the chocolate on the outside of it?
Oh, look, it took a little while to get him up, the big fella, but he's up there now.
Lovely.
Oh, look at this. This there is just beautiful.
There we go. Hey, so Daddy.
We're talking about achievements and playing for Australia, but surely this is a number one, eh?
Here we go.
On the big games, on game day, what's he like? Is he, can you tell he's a bit nervous, or is he pretty calm type of a bloke?
I think generally has, as a person, you know, when I first met him, he taught me patience, and he's generally a very calm person. He doesn't get angry easily, and hardly anything stresses him out. But he tends to sort of take it easy, have a relaxed day, and you know.
Any set routines, any superstitions that he likes to do on the game day?
No, he just likes to, I think, watch the past, you know, footage of him scoring and that, you know, just make sure he can repeat the.
Follow the Newcastle. Glory.
You've got to be back there at dummy half for us, mate, all right? You've got to be there. Can't be late. Beautiful night for footy, Rich.
Yeah.
Good kick and chase, good kick and chase. Run the ball like yourself. As long as our heads are in the right place, as long as we understand what's going to win this, all right? Just all the little effort areas. Don't want your head into all the fancy stuff, just want you into all the effort areas. That's it. All the effort areas. Plenty of talk. Let's go, boys, on our feet. All together.
Full attitude, boys. Full attitude. Anchor, boys. Anchor. Good. All right, let's go for it. Come on, let's go, boys. Let's go, mate.
Now the attention turns to the players, and a terrific battle it should be tonight. These two clubs level on 10 competition points, so ready for a start in Friday night football. The last tackle with Lamb and across Fittler. They had numbers on the right hand side. It's not a great kick. It comes back, fielded by Singh. He's with it 10 metres out. He kicks through. He was tripped, was he? Dropped there by Petheridge.
All right, just give yourself 30 seconds. Just close your eyes there. Get that shit out of your heads. Get that first half out of our heads. Got 40 to go. Have a relax. Take some deep breaths. Forget about all that. All right, just while you're there, just have a think to yourself. Am I in the game? Am I doing the things I want to do? How's me chalk? How's me half a yard? All the little things. Just give yourself 30 seconds. Get all that out. All right, come back to me. We know they're going to try and pull a rabbit out of their hat. 12 beyond on the scoreboard, that's their game. It's going to be a shit kick, it's going to be a grubber kick, it's going to be a flick pass, it's going to be a throw it on the ground and hope someone scoops it up. They'll go for miracles, but they're quite capable of it because of the speed that they've got. You're playing great football, you're playing great football. Let's not bring it on undone by trying to entertain everybody, all right, and lose sight of the fact that we need these 2 points and we've got to move on. All right, who kicks off? We do. Beautiful. We start the platform straight away. Starting 13, straight back to the field. Let's rip it into these blokes and start again, OK?
Sorry,
Freddie, could you talk to me about those? Just be careful. When we kick downfield, on the first play of the ball, see how all their forwards stand in our defence line? And that's where Petherbridge went through. Be very careful and remind the referee when you go back out.
Let's go, guys.
Ready then for the second half in Friday Night Football. And it is a 12-point deficit for the North Sydney Bears to start the second 40.
Oh, no. How can he tell from back there?
Well, that looks pretty forward, doesn't it? I'll let him have that one.
And he's with it from the 30-metre line. Time is up here at the stadium. And the Roosters, they've made it six straight.
There's a win. Loses to 12.
Super effort. Geez, I'm really proud of that tonight. That was a great win. Yeah, and they're no duds either. Terrific effort. But you know what? It's only round seven. We've got to get up and go again tomorrow. Great performance, fellas. Very proud of you.
Hi, Tiger. Welcome to Sydney, Australia.
Thank you. Thank you.
Appreciate Just got a spot that. Over here for you on the driving range.
Thank you.
For practice.
Thank you. Thanks.
Ah!
Sorry. Just can't.
Hey!
I'm sorry.
Which way are you going, Paul? Which way are you going, Paul?
What?
Which way are you going, Paul?
I'm going for the Eels, Peter. I think the fact that Jason Smith is playing five.
Which way are you going, Paul?
I do like the Eels.
It's not funny.
I know.
It's not funny you like the Eels.
I think they'll score plenty of tries. While Cronulla, as far as them scoring tries is concerned, too much dependence on the bomb. Did I say something wrong?
No. As far as them is concerned,
I think they'll score plenty of tries. Cronulla, as far as them try.
What's wrong? I don't know. Slow down. Slow down. Which way are you going, Paul?
The Eels.
Hey, boys. Good to see you back.
Marty, how are
you? Ah, you perish of blue. Loved you guys.
Yes. Yeah,
hey, now you've done everything. Snowboarding,
yeah.
Killed it.
Yeah.
Step.
Easy.
Okay. I reckon we're going to take it up a step. You've heard of the jumper cash in the pool. Plenty of height. Get the distance.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Love cash. We're going to practice today. We're going to jump
any,
it up.
Any with. Of us like, have we ski jump before?
Maddie.
I don't know.
I actually have never skied.
He's a big jumper.
Well, so you'll go well.
Too easy.
Easy for you. You've got it nailed. Righto. So,
someone show us how to skate.
Well, we've got Mike, Hot Dog Mike. You remember him. He's your favourite instructor.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, he's going to go first. Demonstrate, and then we're going to go through a few steps. Get you blokes over the jump.
Sweet.
Thanks, Barney. It's a piece of cake. All we're going to do, guys, just get nice and low. Look for the landing. We want to see some big air. Okay. Arms out so you keep your balance, and it's all good to go. Let's go. Up the door, fellas. Who's up?
Okay, Chief. You're at the top of the jump site. You ready for it?
You've got it
in your mind.
What you got to do? Bottom line is to absorb.
Yep,
I guess my knees are stiff as you know what.
Pipe the jump, off the jump, absorb the jump, ski your way into it. Yeah. Plenty
the boys
of height.
Are down the bottom watching me, aren't they?
They're ready. The judges are ready.
Come on, Chief. Come on, champ.
I look after the world, mate.
Do your best, mate. Watch your cruise ships.
It's okay.
All right, boys. Take come. Hey, Dad, come down.
Gotcha.
No, all I'm right. All right. Okay, I'm all right. Are you stay up there?
Okay, Daddy, ready? You're up for this, aren't you?
I'm not that confident.
We've been training. You're in training. Look, this is good. Well, you're going to get the cash.
Sweet.
Not good. Chest, I'm gone.
Wow, that's the guts that's seen him win premiership.
I've done four rings.
Okay, so what we're going to do here, Stella, you ready for this? All right.
No.
In run, down we go, nice and comfortable. Up. And absorb your landing, right? Don't want to go over the front like that other bloke.
Come on, champ! State of Origin, 86, remember?
Come on.
Come on, mate. You can do it. Get some speed up, champ. Look at the speed.
No, no, good. No, thanks for your support.
You can't do it next week.
We'll come down for you. Wait, don't touch the leg, the leg.
That's all right. I've seen this all before on TV. It looks very easy. I don't need any tips, OK?
You sure?
Mate.
Come on.
Please.
You lean forward.
Hard.
Go up.
Well done, mate. Well done, mate. You absolutely killed
your feet. You landed on your feet.
Now landed on his ass.
Better boys. Tell you what, I could have really hurt myself.
Fat, let's just have one more look at that jump of yours.
St. George starting to look more like the settled, dangerous team we know, especially with a couple of their star performers coming back.
That's right, Pete. Tony Mundine and...
Close win, I'm sorry, against the Western Reds. We'll have his minds on the job.
Paul Harrigan to lead from the front. They've got some very great backs in, of course, the Johns brothers. Look them to them to guide them wearing the...
Oh. And Paul Vorton, when you look through their side, you can understand why.
That's right. Oh.
Facts and figures point to a Roosters victory, but Paul Vorton something...
Paul Vorton. Vorton. On the burst. Vorton on the burst.
Oh, yeah, no.
Shut up. You're a mean no one to do this.
Stop telling him to shut up. The sole unbeaten leaders of the competition, the Sydney City Roosters. Facts and figures...
I'm waiting.
The sole unbeaten leaders of the competition, the Sydney City Roosters. Facts...
come to me.
And really consolidate a top four spot.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Because you're just... You can't look at me.
You've got to. You've got to do it. Just pull yourself together.